Hello students, this is the second part of the video on vector identities. In this we will be discussing three vector identities. The first of them is divergence of f into vector a. So f is a scalar function and a is the vector point function. So this will be f into divergence of vector a plus gradient f dot vector a. Now that by definition, divergence of a vector, this is summation dou a1 by dou x. Now divergence of f into vector a, this should be summation dou by dou x of, now a1 is the coefficient of I cap in vector a. When we take f into vector a, coefficient of I cap would be f into a1. That is because f into vector a is f a1 I cap plus f a2 j cap plus f a3 k cap. Since we have product of two functions here, we need to apply the product rule for differentiation. That results in dou f by dou x into a1 plus f into dou a1 by dou x. Now this is dou f by dou x into a1 plus f into summation dou f1 by dou x. Now this is because on the expansion of summation, a1, a2 and a3 are replaced by cyclic change, x, y, z are replaced by cyclic change. So f will repeat every time we expand, every time we write the term, the second term of this expansion would be f into dou a2 by dou y. Third term would be f into dou a3 by dou z. So f is a common term, therefore we can take it outside the summation. Now, dot product of two vectors, this is summation a1 b1, where a1, a2, a3 are components of vector a, b1, b2, b3 are components of vector b. Therefore, the dot product of two vectors will be summation a1 b1, which on expansion gives us a1 b1 plus a2 b2 plus a3 b3. Now if you observe the first summation, we have dou f by dou x into a1. So dou f by dou x is coefficient of I cap in grad f. A1 is coefficient of I cap in vector A. Therefore, the first summation should be dot product of grad f and vector A. So, divergence of f into vector A will be grad f dot vector a plus f into, by definition this is divergence of vector a. The next identity would be curl of f into vector A. The curl of vector A is dou A3 by dou y minus dou A2 by dou z I cap, so which for which we take summation. So curl of f into vector A will be dou by dou y of the k component of f into vector A, that is f A3, minus dou by dou z of f A2. So this will result in summation dou by dou f by dou y A3 plus f into dou A3 by dou y minus dou f by dou z A2 plus f into dou A2 by dou z. Now we need to rearrange the similar terms, so that will give us summation f into dou A3 by dou y minus dou A2 by dou z plus dou f by dou y A3 minus dou f by dou z A2 I cap. Now I can split this as two summations. So f into summation dou A3 by dou y minus dou A2 by dou z I cap. Again, f being a scalar can be taken outside the summation, plus summation dou f by dou y into A3 minus dou f by dou z into A2. Now the first summation is nothing but curl of vector A. Now the second summation, we will have a look at what is A cross B. That is I, J, K, A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3. We will just write the first component, that will be A2, B3 minus A3, B2 into I cap. Now A1, A2 is dou f by dou y, A3 is dou f by dou z. Instead of B3 we have capital A3, instead of B2 we have capital A2. That means this is cross product of two vectors. So this also implies A1 is dou f by dou x. So if A1, A2, A3 are these partial derivatives, then vector A is gradient of f. So we have curl of f into vector A, this is equal to f into curl of vector A plus, this would be vector A is grad f and vector B is vector A. The last of the vector identities is divergence of A cross B, which is curl A dot B minus A dot curl B. Now to prove this, first we have A cross B, which is I J K A1 A2 A3 B1 B2 B3. So the first term would be summation A2 B3 minus A3 B2 I cap. Now divergence of F is summation dou F1 by dou X. F is equal to A cross B implies F1 is A2 B3 minus A3 B2. Therefore, divergence of A cross B, this is summation dou by dou x of A2 B3 minus A3 B2. So applying the properties of derivatives, we have dou A2 by dou x into B3 plus A2 dou B3 by dou x minus dou A3 by dou x B2 plus A3 dou B2 by dou x. Now to find, identify curl A dot B, we need appropriate terms to identify. Now when we say divergence curl A dot B, we require the coefficient of B1 in the first term so that we can identify it with the summation. So what we would do is expand the summation. So this will result in dou A2 by dou X B3 plus A2 dou B3 by dou X minus dou A3 by dou X B2 plus A3 dou B2 by dou X. The next term would, the next set of next four terms will have derivatives of Y. A2, A1, A2, A3, B1, B2 and B3, they change in cyclic order. So dou by dou Y of A2 becomes A3, B3 becomes B1 plus A3 dou B1 by dou Y minus, sorry, this should be a minus sign here. A3 becomes A1, B2 becomes B3. And the last four terms will be derivatives of Z. So A3 becomes A1, B1 becomes B2. Now we'll collect for curl A dot B, we require coefficients of B1, and for A dot curl B, we require coefficients of A1. So we'll come back to the summation. Now curl A dot B, that means we require coefficient of B1 minus coefficient of A1. So coefficient of B1, the first of them is here. So we have dou A3 by dou Y. The second one is here. So we have minus dou A2 by dou Z. Now here we have taken minus A1 out. So first we look for minus A1, that is here. So you have dou B3 by dou Y, and if you look at this, because of that, interchanging of A and B should give me this result. So we have coefficient of minus A1 is dou B3 by dou Y, and we also have A1 here. Because we have taken minus A1 out, we should have minus dou B2 by dou Z. So this will be summation dou A3 by dou Y minus dou A2 by dou Z into B1 minus summation A1 into dou B3 by dou Y minus dou B2 by dou Z. So this will be curl of A dot vector B minus vector A dot curl B. So this is the vector identity that we needed. So divergence of A cross B is equal to curl of A dot B minus A dot curl B.